Hi everyone, my name is Leah Kopke and I'm a 3D motion design freelancer. In each one of these episodes, we go over another 3D modeling tool for Cinema 4D. And today's 3D modeling tool is Brush. So let's jump into Cinema 4D and show how it works. Here we are inside of Cinema 4D. The very first thing I'll do is I'll go over to my primitives and I'll drop in a plane. I'll make sure that my display mode includes lines so that we can see our segments within our scene. And I'll change my width of my plane to 150 by 150. And I'll increase our segments in width and height to about 100 for both. And I'll hit the C hotkey, which will make this editable. And you can also hit this icon here. It does the same thing. And once we have that, now we can show how this tool works. So the hotkey for brush is MC. So I'll click the M button and you'll see C is in the drop-down menu. So we can hit C. And something that you'll notice about the brush settings is that they look really similar to the magnet settings that we had covered previously. So if you're interested in checking out that tutorial, that's the one from last week, and I'll leave a link to it in the description below so that you can check it out if you'd like. And you'll notice we have the same settings here, like size, and you can adjust these the same way as with the magnet tool. If you hold down the middle mouse button and drag your mouse right, you'll increase the size. If you drag it left, you'll decrease the size while holding that middle mouse button. You can also use the right and left brackets. Right makes it bigger, left makes it smaller. So there's a few different ways to adjust this here. You can adjust the strength of your tool, and that's basically how much this brush will affect the surface we are sculpting on. I find it easier to do this on a Cintiq, so I'm working on my Cintiq for today and I have my Cintiq pen here, but you can also do this with a mouse. It's just a little bit more challenging to control what you're doing with a mouse. You'll see we have different modes here. For right now, I'm going to choose surface just to, as an example, to show the strength. And if I drag my mouse over here, you can see that that's it with the strength at 50. I'll hit undo, Control Z on PC, Command Z on Mac, and we'll increase the strength to 100%. And you can see it's a lot more intense. Control Z or Command Z. I'll make it something really small, like 5%. You can see we're just barely affecting the surface at all. Like, you can barely see it on my screen now. So I'll hit undo. So you can control your strength by doing that. We have all the same settings here actually as magnet. So if you know what these are for the magnet tool that we covered last week, you pretty much know what they are here. And you have the same fall off settings as with the magnet tool. You have the same restriction settings as with the magnet tool, and they work really similar. The main difference between the brush tool and the magnet tool is that the magnet tool, it just affects that one point within the radius of your tool, whereas with the brush tool, it's more of like you're drawing on the surface. You can move your mouse around and it will continue to affect it. Whereas if you were to do this with the magnet tool, and maybe I'll pull up the magnet tool just to show you. So this is how this would work with the brush tool. If I pull up the magnet tool with the hotkey MI, then let's say we still have the setting on normal and I pull my brush, you'll see we aren't drawing on the surface It's only affecting that initial area where I clicked. So that's the main difference between the two tools. I'll hit undo and I'll go back to my brush tool with MC. And now here we are here again. We have the option smear, and this works much like how it sounds. It basically lets you smear around the surface. So that's pretty crazy looking because I have the strength all the way up. I'll reduce that a little bit. We can smear around the surface, kind of like adding butter to some toast. That's how that works. Our next option up is pull. And instead of just smearing it, what pull does is it actually pulls the surface towards the camera. So I'll show you what I mean here. I'll just use this brush again, but on the setting pull, and you can see that this is actually pulling towards the camera. And the camera is invisible. It's the thing we're looking through on Cinema 4D. And you can see that's pulling it towards our invisible camera that we're looking through when we use it. If I were to move the camera over here instead and do the same thing, it'll pull in that direction since that's where the camera is. So that's how that works. Our next option up here is surface, and surface will pull the surface in the normal direction using the center normal of your cursor. So the center point of our cursor right here, the center point, that's where it will choose the normal direction from in order to pull the surface. So I can go through here and just pull the surface up in the normal direction. And you can see what that's doing there. Now, this next setting is very similar, but a little bit different. It's actually kind of hard to see the difference between them. But if you choose normal, it's using the normal direction of everywhere within the radius of your selection instead of just the center in order to choose what is the normal direction we're pulling this in. So I'll choose that. And since they look very similar, hopefully this will help you better understand what is happening when we do that, even though they look very similar. Repel is a fun one. I'll show you what that does. It repels things in a circular direction relative to the direction of the camera again. So if I move the camera over here, and I do the same thing over here, you'll see they're facing two different directions, but it creates that circular shape and repels those polygons circularly. Our next option here is spin. I'll hit undo a few times again. Spin literally spins the surface around, so that's kind of fun. We can make a nice little swirl here spinning the surface around. And this tool's real fun, in all honesty. Maybe you could use this to 3D model a seashell, because that looks like a seashell kind of shape to me. And that's a total option for you. You can also use twister mode. So I'll hit undo on our seashell shape, and we're going to use twister mode and show what that does. So twister is very similar, but you'll notice it works a little bit different. So it still spins those polygons, but also pulls them outwards. So it works a little bit differently. If we go into vortex, it spins the polygons and pulls them out, but it pulls them out in the direction of the camera. So you can see we end up with something that kind of looks like a unicorn horn. That's what that does. You have this next option called smooth. So if I were to go back into repel just to mess up the surface a little bit, to show how this works, and we want to smooth this out, you can choose the smooth mode, and then we just can smooth these areas out, and you can see how nicely that smooths them out. there's another option similar to that. So I'm going to mess up the surface here again with repel and create that crazy mess of polygons there. That's probably too high of a strength for repel. That's not the neatest geometry. But if you go into relax, what that'll do is it'll relax the surface relative to the other polygons and geometry around those edges and polygons. So the smooth smooths things out in a more general fashion, but relax does it relative to what's around it. So it can be a nice option for if you want to keep your edge loops nice and neat while you smooth things out. It's a good option for that. That's how that works. I'm going to hit undo a few times to get rid of these. That's Control Z on PC or Command Z on a Mac. Then since we've gone through all of these options, you'll notice we have some more options here. But I think what I'll want to do is go through some of these fall off options first. So the fall off is basically the shape or in which your brush is affecting the surface. So we went through this a little bit with the magnet tool and actually find that these different types of fall offs are easier to see with the magnet tool. So I might show them quickly with the magnet tool first, and then we'll show them with the brush tool. So if you already learned the magnet tool, this will be a very quick review. I'll try to keep it quick and easy for you. MI, in case if you've already seen this, if I hit MI, I'll pull open our magnet tool, and I'm going to pull this in the normal direction. I have the strength on 100%. I'm going to show you what the bell shape looks like. This is the bell shape of the fall off. We have constant, that's the constant shape fall off. Linear, this is the linear shape fall off. We have dome, this is the dome shape fall off for the brush. Circle, this is the circle shape fall off. Needle shape fall off. Spline, you can make your own crazy shape if you'd like with the spline. You can hit control and click at the same time. So maybe I'll add an extra point right here using control and clicking again. And then I can drag the surface up and you can see we have a totally new shape that we've made with that fall off by adjusting the spline. Now the same thing works with the brush tool, except instead of affecting one point on the surface, it's going to be affecting wherever our mouse actually drags. So I'll hit undo a bunch of times and I'll use MC in order to pull up the brush tool again. And we can choose any one of these shapes. Like, let's choose constant. And choose, instead of relax, let's use normal. And you can see that now we're pulling up the surface here with that fall off shape. So you can choose whatever fall off shape you'd like. I'm going to make our brush a little bit smaller with the left bracket, and let's go ahead and just roughly 3D model in some lips. They're not going to be perfect. I'm doing this quickly. So now we have some, like a rough shape of a pair of lips that we've 3D modeled with the brush tool. And the reason why I did that was I want to show you this other option. And also, if you hold down shift and drag your mouse or your pen, if you're using a Cintiq, it'll smooth things out a little bit. And then you don't have to go all the way in this drop down menu to find smooth as an option. But we did that. And then you'll see we have this option here called surface. And if I turn this on, it'll move what we have here, but it'll focus on wherever the center of our brush is. So if I wanted to, let's say, smear this, we're affecting more of the center of the brush than what's on the outer edges of the brush. If I turn off surface, it's affecting everything else within that radius a whole lot more, as you can see. So turning on surface just gives you more control if you're doing high detailed type of work. Preview allows you to see the circle shape of round your cursor. If we turn that off, you no longer see it. You just see my arrow cursor. I like to see the circle in the preview. It helps me know the size of my brush. Visible only means you'll be only affecting what's visible from the camera view. You can choose to restrict what direction you're moving polygons, edges, and points. And you can do this in either world coordinates or object coordinates. So world coordinates are the coordinate system you see up here in the corner in the right of your viewport. And then object coordinates can actually differ from world coordinates. So if I zoom out and I hit E, you can see these are the object coordinates of this plane. If I were to move this plane that way and click E again, you can see that our object coordinates are not lining up with the world coordinates. So if I go back into our tool with MC, you can see you can choose which coordinates you are affecting. You can affect the strength of the brush in the X direction, X axis, Y axis, or Z axis. And that's what this controls. And then you'll also notice that you have the same fall off options as with the magnet tool. So it's very similar. It basically works pretty much the same as the magnet tool, except that you can move your mouse and it'll affect more than just that initial area where you clicked and that initial radius. And I feel like this tool is actually a really great introduction before we get into all the other sculpting tools. So if we go up into the mesh menu, you can see our different tools here, but if we go all the way down to sculpt and brushes, you can see that we have this entire menu full of brush tools, and they work very similarly. These ones are actually more powerful than just the simplified brush tool, and we'll definitely get into all of these options here. And if you ever want to dock this in your screen, you can always grab this dotted edge right here, and then you can dock it anywhere you'd like so that those tools are always available to you. And that's just something to be aware of while you're working. And I really hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you did and you'd like to be notified of more 3D modeling tool tutorials, please hit like and subscribe. And I'll see you next week on Ambient 3D Animations. Thank you for watching.